Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Demonologist, The Extraordinary Career of Ed, and Lorraine Warren, The Paranormal Investigators, featured in the film The Conjuring Book by Gerald Brittle. This book is a must for those newly interested in various aspects of the paranormal. This is just another short list of demonic cases and events experienced by the Warrens. Bad enough in the days of paperbacks, it would be worse now that there are Kindles. Felt that the book could have done without at least 100 pages because it went over subjects already discussed in earlier chapters. Read this book, folks, and then keep your eyes open to the world around you. This book gives the background of Ed and Lorraine Warren, and a history of some of the most frightening cases. Also, his website has a lot of info that ties into this subject of the spiritual world. While not an easy subject to explore, demon possession is nonetheless important to learn about and become equipped to fight against. As they say, knowledge is power, and that is exactly what this book's attempts to impart. It was interesting reading about Ed and Lorraine Warren's career, and how they became demonologists in the first place. In addition to their experiences, they offer a wealth of information along the way on how to protect oneself from demon possession, and what signs and symptoms to look for if it has, indeed, taken place. In fact, this book is used as a textbook in some classes for such a purpose. For those who want to know more about demonology, this is the book for you. Love this unique couple. Cool to find out there's more behind the movies, and even greater stories. This book isn't for everybody. This is a serious book about what can happen when you are faced with a preternatural. This is not a joke, and if you've ever had the misfortune of dealing with darkness brush against you, oh, you know how it feels, because words fail to describe sheer terror. You would think, with all the research they've done, that this book would be a real page-turner, but, alas no. This is a great book that gives highlights on the most popular cases to publication point that they were most frequently asked about, but gives a warning to those who think it's all a game, and teaches that it's not all Hollywood's lights. It's not frightening, unless you are someone who plays with Ouija boards, or likes to dabble in the occult, you have been warned. This is a very well-written and interesting book on a subject that all should be aware of. It is all too easy to call prey to evil forces, and possibly lose your eternal soul. There are areas where the writing is a bit choppy, but that is to be expected with any book these days. This book is written so well, and in a sort of question-answer format without it looking or seeming like an interview. With all the developing reality TV shows like Ghost Hunters, Ghost Adventures, Celebrity Ghost Stories, and Paranormal State, the interest in what happens in the afterlife is becoming more and more obvious. This is a great read on where two individuals have documented their own experiences as factual as they are able to describe, leaving plenty of room for firm believers and skeptics. This book was very informative. No matter what your beliefs may be, there are certain aspects of life and realms in this world that no human can fully understand. It gives the true details of what really happened in these cases, in which Hollywood has made great fortune on putting their little twist on it. Highly recommend this book. It's a long and fascinating QA session with the Warrens, who are one of the most intriguing couples of the past half century, because they have not only encountered strange and evil things, but they have endured the sometimes murderous interest of the demonic, completely outside of their casework, if their accounts are to be believed. And if they are, then Ed and Lorraine are some truly sturdy people who have an abiding respect for God, and a genuine and deep interest in the welfare of people who have tripped into dangerous things. Some parts are really entertaining and are an easy read, then there are some technical parts. If you are serious about possession, demonic spirits, or are just religious and want to explore a bit, then this is the perfect place to stop. This book tells of some of their experiences, but also show they are nice people drawn into a life to help others. The real deal of their career, and how it was similar different compared to the details from the movie, was interesting. The variety of the experiences they had, and how visceral, without being over-sensationalized, no heads turning around or split pea soup here, made them believable, scary, and a bit closer to real life than many of the movies on the subject. Speaking from experience, it's easy to be a skeptic until you see these things happen to and around you. It teaches you the signs of different types of hauntings, and the dangers of doing anything to try and get attention from demons. Reading it is so much better than watching it. It's a really great book, and shows details about all their case files. It's really great. This book takes a clear-eyed and calm look at the strange career of the Wardens, and what information they have found to be true about the spirit world. Teach us what to do, and not to do to keep demons and devils out of your life. Even if only 20 of these occurrences are accurate, the Warrens have led an extraordinarily whirlwind life worthy of film, and a life to take notice of. Good book. Whether you have had paranormal experiences, are currently living in a haunted house, or are simply curious, thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe, and leave your comments below.